Kampala Lord Mayor Elias Lukwago has advised councillors to work together with the technical side of the authority if service delivery they promised to the electorates is to be achieved. Lukwago was speaking ahead of the elections of the Kampala Capital City Authority Speaker at the City Hall in Kampala that saw National Unity Platform is Zahara Mara Muyelekila and Yusuf Masaba take both the office of the Speaker and the Deputy Speaker. Lukwago also asked the councillors to always respect each other while in the council meetings. His call comes after the National Unity Platform has over 43 councillors, while FDC having 3 and NRM 8.
We have our political differences, but let us respect one another here as we deliberate in council. In whatever situation, we can conduct ourselves as village council. It can be a very remote village, I mentioned one village. But you can all imagine of how village councils sometimes conduct themselves without any guiding rules. So use this as a tool to guide you, respecting the decorum. On my part, I make total commitment, deep from my heart, to work closely.
Lukwago did not participate in the elections of the speaker, saying that he wanted the councillors to take their stand without his intervention.
Stay and leave the decision to the councillors to take whichever way. I would like to give them their independence to take their own decision without any form of undue influence. So permit me, your worship.
Mara Zahara Muyelekila won the speakership race with 43 votes, beating NRM's Namsisi Shamim, who tallied with 8 votes.
I therefore now declare Mara
Muyelekila, after assuming her office as Speaker for Kampala Capital City Authority, did ask government to find tax holidays for the business community in Kampala as they try to bring their businesses back. She further advises the councillors to advise the electorates about the COVID-19 pandemic, especially adhering to the standard operating procedures.
It's not been secret that the global pandemic COVID-19 is still at large. You are encouraged to mobilize your communities to adhere to the SOPs and also undergo ongoing vaccination exercise. Since the pandemic has hit our business community, honorable members, it is therefore prudent that we ask central government to provide a stimulus package to our business communities so as which contributes a 70% of the taxes in Kampala. This can rightly be achieved through exempting the people of Kampala from paying property tax and trading license until the economy recovers.
Muyelekila also did advise the councillors to deliver diligently their promises towards their electorates.
Far we should ensure that we deliver diligently, bearing in mind that we are at the helm of the Kampala Capital City Authority. This can only be achieved through dedication, regular attendance and punctuality in all various settings, such as thus setting a perfect example to the people of Kampala and Uganda at large. Members.
However, the councillors we spoke to after the elections did speak out those things that they are going to do for the electorates, but too spoke about the finances that was put by other sides to bribe the various councillors.
We want to make sure that our people do not stay with garbages in their houses or near their houses. Our point one is garbage in Kampala, and it should be free of charge. There is no reason why a person of Kampala pays taxes on each and everything, almost even where he steps.
Well, amid these all challenges, the Lord councillors and different councillors have faced, a lot of money was dispersed to buy them off, but they have stood with the people and they have voted wisely. We have so much hope and we are interested in the city. That's why we are here today at KCCA, to make sure we stand in solidarity and we affirm them, whatever decision they have made.
No, not at all. We didn't bribe any councillor here. Actually, it has been them who have been dishing out money and threatening their colleagues. that you know what, if you don't vote for us, after us giving us our money, you will get the repercussions from Magere. That's why you do see them going with the phones, and even the judge asked them, why are you taking phones to the voting place? They're accounting for the money they received from their bosses.
I'm very, very, very sure that we have not gone to anywhere of our struggle. So I plead to them that they are command centers of the struggle here at KCCA. I plead to the speaker and the deputy speaker as well to add on the voices that have already been shouted loud to, for our fallen our comrades in prisons.
Muyili Kila becomes the first female speaker for Kampala Capital City Authority after Abubakar Kawalya from the FDC.
I, Mala, Zahara, Inika, swear in the name of the Almighty that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve.
Brian Sinkumba, Channel 44 Prime News.